Hello everyone, I'm Ji Yun Bu. I'm a graduate student of Nanocentrating Systems Laboratory in Bio and Brain Engineering Department. Today's lecture will be about the metabolism of cancer cell. Contents are as followed. First, I'll introduce you why targeting cancer cell became important in cancer therapies. Left figure shows 5-year survival of major cancer sites and right figure shows breast cancer survival rate. As you can see, in most cases, cancer survival rate has been increased recently. It appears to be improved, but if we look into details, unsolved problems still exist. First, for the sites having difficulties in early diagnosis of cancer, such as lung or pancreatic, survival rates are still low. As you can see in the graphs, survival rate remained lower than 10% for the past 30 years. Next, for the cancers over stage 4, survival rate decreased dramatically. Therefore, current therapeutic drugs are not appropriate therapy for targeting universality of cancer nature. Before introducing new candidate for targeting cancer, let's see how cancer therapies have evolved. It was found that the mutations in gene which control normal cell proliferation can lead to cancer. The mutations that contribute to the development of cancer affect three general classes of gene. First are oncogenes. Oncogenes are genes whose presence in certain forms and overactivity can stimulate the development of cancer. In many cases, oncogenes arise from the mutation of proto-oncogenes. Therefore, oncogenes resemble proto-oncogenes in that they code for the production of protein involved in growth control. However, oncogenes code for an altered version of these growth control proteins, thereby disrupting a cell's growth signaling pathway. However, tumor suppressor genes are normal genes whose absence can lead to cancer. Since tumor suppressor genes code for protein that slow down cell growth and division, the loss of such proteins allows a cell to grow and divide in an uncontrolled fashion. Now, for DNA repair genes, they code for proteins whose normal function is to correct errors that arise when cells duplicate their DNA prior to cell division. Mutations in DNA repair genes can lead to a failure in DNA repair, which in turn allows subsequent mutations in tumor suppressor genes and proto-oncogenes to accumulate. Therefore, previous cancer therapies focused on repairing these genes. However, it was found that oncogenes cannot provide answer for cancer therapy. After Human Genome Project was completed, many researchers looked into cancer genomes. Overall, 510 tumors from 507 patients were subjected to whole exome sequencing, identifying more than 30,000 somatic mutations among 177 cancer genes. This means that empiric probability is 2 to the 500, which suggests that it is almost impossible to identify the role of individual gene. Also, even among tumors arising from the same tissue, they exhibit heterogeneous alterations. Different accessibility to various nutrients, changes in signaling mechanisms, and genetic alteration all influence heterogeneity of cancer. So, it can be concluded that previous inductive methods are not appropriate for cancer therapy. More general and universal therapeutic methods are required for the cancer. This figure illustrates some of the many approaches employed in developing therapeutic targeted to the known and emerging hallmarks of cancer. In the earlier version of this illustrate, only 8 approaches are introduced. However, 2 of different approaches, which are in red box, are added. These approaches are targeting universality of cancer nature and they are all based on the deductive method. Most of scientific research is based on inductive method. In inductive method, a causing factor must prove the result. In contrast, in deductive method, a causing factor explains the result. If we apply it to the cancer therapy, previous somatic mutation targeted therapy, which seeks and fixes abnormal gene expression, is based on inductive method. However, since all the cancer cells have different metabolism compared to the normal cells, targeting cell metabolism can be a good example of deductive method. Before going into cancer, to help your understanding, I will give one good example of how deductive methods are used in biopharmaceuticals. Sulfur mustard is well used in chemical warfare. Autopsy of dead body found dramatic decrease of white blood cells. They applied analogs to Hodgkin's disease and other lymphomas. Now, let's get back to the topic and see how deductive method can be applied in general cancer therapy. Cancer cells have altered metabolism, which is called Warburg effect or aerobic glycolysis. By controlling metabolism, it will be possible to specifically target cancer cells. First, I will briefly introduce you what Warburg effect is. Cancer cells tend to convert most of glucose to lactate, no matter how much oxygen is available. This process is called aerobic glycolysis or Warburg effect. In this process, only about 10% of ATP is generated compared to oxidative phosphorylation. Aerobic glycolysis is less efficient than oxidative phosphorylation for generating ATP because for proliferating cells, it is required to generate not only ATP, but also various biomasses. Targeting cell metabolism is beneficial because of three reasons. First, metabolism may influence cancer initiation and progression. Second, targeting metabolism could improve existing approaches. Finally, metabolism is a proven target of successful therapies. For targeting cancer cell metabolisms, such compounds have the potential to limit macromolecular synthesis needed for cell growth. Alternatively, there are compounds that can limit pathways that are important for supplying nutrients to the cell and impair bioenergetics. Therefore, approaches for targeting cancer cell metabolism include these five in black boxes. Now, I will give some examples of targeting cancer metabolism. Tumors contain oxygenated and hypoxic regions, so the tumor cell population is heterogeneous. Cancer cells use glucose under hypoxia and lactate under normoxia. Inhibiting MCT1 with CHC or siRNA in these cells induced a switch from lactate-fueled respiration to glycolysis. This retarded tumor growth as the hypoxic glycolytic tumor cells died from glucose starvation and rendered the remaining cells sensitive to irradiation. As MCT1 was found to be expressed by an array of primary human tumors, it was suggested that inhibition has clinical anti-tumor potential. Many researchers focused on finding metabolic enzyme that is critical in proliferation and other metabolic mechanisms in cancer cells. Pink circles are metabolic enzymes that are currently being considered as therapeutic targets for cancer. Another important discovery was found from diabetic patients. It has been found that cancer incidence and mortality have decreased in diabetic patients with breast cancer receiving metformin and neoadjuvant chemotherapy. With this fact, it has been proved that metformin induces AMPK that inhibits cell proliferation. Now I will introduce you one more interesting discovery and end this part. Novartis announced that rapamycin failed in the phase 3 clinical trial. The main reason appears to be autophagy, which supports the growth of the late-stage cancers by supplying biosynthetic intermediates through recycling organelles under harsh conditions. Most cancer drugs trigger autophagy in cancer that benefits late-stage cancer for survival. Therefore, various experiments were conducted and the relationship between autophagy inhibition and anti-cancer activity was proved. However, clinical trials are not reported yet. Some key issues for targeting cancer cell metabolism is as followed. There are challenges of directly targeting metabolic pathways because all cells rely on the same metabolic pathways to generate ATP. Also, metabolic flux in cancer cells is not well understood. In addition, genetic events define an ideal set of possible targets for cancer therapy, but unfortunately, many of the gene products are transcription factors or signaling molecules that rely on protein-to-protein interaction and present challenges to drug development. This is the end of my presentation. I recommend you to read summary part by yourself. Thank you for your attention.